अस्सलाम वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। क्लास सिक्स, वेलकम टू योर साइंस क्लास। वी वर डिस्कसिंग द चैप्टर कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ फूड, इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द ऑल न्यूट्रिएंट ग्रुप्स प्रेजेंट इन द फूड एंड वी हैव आल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट द बैलेंस्ड डाइट। इफ यू डू नॉट ईट अ बैलेंस्ड डाइट देन वॉट हैपन्स यू नो, देन देर विल बी लैक ऑफ एनी न्यूट्रिएंट इन योर बॉडी एंड there may be excessive intake of any nutrient in your body. Lack of nutrient, any of the nutrient in your body for a long period of time may cause disease in your body, and this disease is called as deficiency disease. There are many deficiency disease. The first type of deficiency disease that we are going to discuss is protein deficiency disease. And that is protein deficiency disease, and it is also called as kwashiorkor. The main system of this disease are that the skin becomes dry and scaly, hair becomes dry, body swells up, and a pot-like belly emerges out, and legs becomes bone and thinny. You can see this picture of the baby, a child. He is suffering from protein deficiency disease. See, his belly is pot-like. Then the next deficiency disease is protein carbohydrate fat deficiency disease. The main symptoms of this disease are the body becomes lean and thin, body becomes so weak that the child is not able to move, skin become dry, thin and wrinkled, ribs become very prominent, sunken eyes, unable to digest food, and also suffers from diarrhea. See this picture of the child who is suffering from protein carbohydrate fat deficiency disease, also called as marasmus. This disease generally affects infants under 1 year of age. You can see this small baby, he is grossly underweight. Then we have discussed about vitamins. You know that vitamins are called protective food because they help to prevent many diseases, and lack of these vitamins also causes diseases. The first vitamin deficiency disease that we are going to discuss is vitamin A deficiency disease, that is called as night blindness. In this disease there is poor vision and the loss of vision in darkness. At night these people cannot see. Then the next is vitamin B1. Lack of vitamin B1 causes beriberi, and in this what happens, there is extreme weakness, swelling of legs, loss of appetite and weight. Then the third disease, that is vitamin C deficiency disease. This disease is known as scurvy, and then this you can see this picture, sponge and bleeding gums, loosening of teeth, and wounds take long time to heal. And the fourth vitamin deficiency disease is caused by the lack of vitamin D, and that is rickets. In rickets, the bones become soft and bent. You can see this picture, the bone becomes soft and bent, and then what happens, the malformation of legs and bones happens, and pain in the bones also occur. Then we have discussed about the nutrient minerals. Minerals are also required in small quantities, and you know that minerals are necessary for the growth of our blood, teeth and bones. So lack of these minerals may also lead to various diseases. The first mineral deficiency disease is disease caused due to lack of iron, and this is called as hemoglobin. In this disease, less hemoglobin is the disease is called as anemia, and in this disease less hemoglobin is produced in blood, and the symptoms are there is weakness and fatigue, loss of weight, pale skin and loss of appetite. The next mineral deficiency disease is iodine deficiency disease, and this is called as goiter. In this disease there is abnormal enlargement of the thyroid gland, and in the you can see this woman, the neck region swells up. There is retarded growth and mental disability also due to lack of iodine in our food. Then next deficiency disease is disease due to lack of calcium. Lack of calcium causes bone and teeth decay. The bones become weak, excessive bleeding of gums and stunted growth, tooth decay and weakness. And the next mineral is fluorine, lack of which causes dental caries. There is pain in the teeth, sensitivity to hot and cold food drinks. This is all deficiency disease. Means disease caused due to lack of one or more nutrients in the food. But excess intake of food also cause some disease. And excess intake of food have a condition which is called obesity. Overeating of fat-rich food leads to overweight condition, which is called obesity. Many people, especially children, eat lot of junk food such as burgers, chips and soft drinks. All these food contains large amount of fat and sugar. Due to lack of physical activities, fat get accumulated in the body and causes obesity. Obese people may suffer from diseases like hypertension, diabetes. We can control obesity and be fit and healthy by proper physical exercise and avoiding fat and carbohydrate rich diet. So this completes your chapter. Go through the chapter, take a revision of the chapter at home, and in the next period we will discuss the exercises and question answers.